I love Christmas. All the food and presents.
Matthew, do you really know the meaning of Christmas?
Dad, can you tell me?
Okay, I'll try my best.
About 2,000 years ago, in a town named Nazareth, there lived a young woman named Mary. One day, something amazing happened. An angel named Gabriel appeared to Mary.
Who are you?
I am Gabriel. God has sent me here to tell you that soon you will have a son.
Me? A son?
Yes, a son. He will be named Jesus.
I will do of God as he wishes, for I am very obedient.
One day, Mary and her husband Joseph were in their house. The Roman Empire sent soldiers to ask for taxes. They were told to go to Bethlehem to pay taxes. Their trip took many days. When they got there, all the inns were full. Finally, they found a small stable to stay in. That night, Jesus was born. There was no crib, so they laid Jesus in a manger. Near Bethlehem, that night, there were some shepherds keeping watch over their flocks of sheep, when suddenly an angel appeared to them.
I have good news for you. There is a Savior that has been born.
What?
Really?
Where is he?
Then the angel told them where to find him. The shepherds were so excited and happy, they ran to the stable, and they found Jesus there just as the angel told them. After they saw Jesus, they went into the town and spread the word to everyone.
Merry Christmas!
To Fake Christmas Demolition.
We're here to destroy all the false ideas about Christmas.
We're trying to get the right mindset for Christmas.
We're reading from the second chapter of the Philippians.
You must have the same attitude that Christ Jesus had.
Though he was God, he did not think of equality with God as something to cling to.
Instead, he gave up his life for the divine privileges.
He took the humble position of a slave and was born as a human being.
When he appeared in human form, he humbled himself in obedience to God and died a criminal's death on a cross.
Christmas, I'm going to have the right attitude.
This Christmas, I'm going to let go of my way.
I knew that.
This Christmas, I'm going to focus more on giving than getting.
This Christmas, I'm going to focus more on serving than getting served.
This Christmas, I'll be humble instead of proud.